Hi everyone, Eric here for Ask Our Experts. We continue to answer questions about memory, and to help answer today's question, we again welcome back Steven Gann. Let's see how we can help. Steven, write protection seems like a very common feature on modern EEPROMs. Could you tell us about write protect and the use cases for it?
Sure, Eric. When working with non-volatile memory, it can be helpful to ensure that all or some of your data is write protected. This can protect your data from being corrupted by a firmware error or malicious tampering, for example. There are different methods for being able to write protect your EEPROMs, like on I2C devices, there's usually a dedicated write protect pin, and it will only allow writes to the device when that pin is pulled high. Depending on your application, you might want to have that write protect pin controlled by a microcontroller, or it could be hardwired to be pulled low in your application if you're able to pre-program the device prior to assembly. Some users will attach it to a hardware jumper or mechanical switch. For SPI devices, there's usually a software write protection in the form of a configuration register, where specific bits map to specific segments in memory and will only allow writes if that a bit is a zero. While those two mechanisms are fairly common across models and manufacturers, specific devices may provide more advanced features. For example, some Microchip I2C EEPROMs include configuration registers with block protect bits so that they will protect that segment of the memory array if the bit is a one, and then there's a lock bit that will permanently lock that configuration. Some SPI EEPROMs include enhanced write protection in the form of memory partition registers, where each of these registers can be provided with a start address, a length, and a behavior so that you can configure custom zones of writable, write protected, and permanently write protected memory.
Thank you, Steven, for explaining write protection as well as the enhanced features. For our viewers, to learn more about adding EEPROM to your designs, visit our website linked in the description below and watch some of our other memory videos from this series anytime. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to be the first to know when we have more insights from our experts. We'll see you again next time.